Welcome back, guys. Today we are going to learn how to interact with SQLite using Python. So let's begin. First of all, we need to import SQLite. Import SQLite 3. Now, first of all, we are creating a signup method. So make another class called signup and pass a resource as a parameter. If you are passing a resource, then we need to import resource from class RESTful. Okay, now in signup method, create one post method. Sorry, in signup class, create one post method and pass self as a parameter. Now fetch the data from the user. So for that data, we need to request.getJSON. Now for that we need to import request. So from class import request, here also from. Now provide the connection to the database. For that connection, which is equal to SQLite3. Connect, provide the data.dbs parameter. So if the database is not created, then this statement create the database, and if already data.db is created, then it will provide connection to it. Now create a cursor, connect.cursor is used in database for the execute the query. Now write the first query. I am just going to copy it. So what this query did, if the table is not created, then it will create the table with the ID, username and password. So for the first user, it will create the table, and for the rest of all the user, it will just insert the data. So cursor execute the query 1. Now write the another query. For the another query, we are going to insert the data. So for that, insert into user, pass the parameter like this, null, question mark. Here ID is going to be null because it is the integer, so it will auto increment. Now we need to provide username and password as a parameter. So for that, execute the query 2 and provide the parameter. So data username, data of password. Like this. Now execute the second query is executed. Now commit to the database. For that, commit and close the connection, and after that return the message that the user is created. So for that, okay, so the signup method is completed. Now we create a new class. So for that we need to create another endpoint. So go to the main API file, here api.addResource, and here signup with the endpoint, like you can say /signup. Well, we need to import signup over here. So from user, import the signup. Now go to the security file which we are using for sign in. Here username and UID mapping used for the sign in method. So remove all this. Don't need this anymore. save it. Now get back to the user file. Here in this user class, define the method, call it find by username, where pass self and username as a parameter, provide the connection and create the cursor for that. Now here write the query where selecting the particular username, so select star from user where username equal to question mark. Here we need to pass this username. Now using the cursor, execute this query. So cursor dot execute the Q1 and pass the username as a parameter. Here check the syntax of the passing the parameter. In the database, you can pass parameter using tuple. If you want to pass a single value in the tuple, so you need to put a comma. So save the fetch data into the result. So result equal to this one. Now we are going to fetch particular one user into the row. So for that row, which is equal to result.fetch one. Now we are going to check that user is exist or not. So for that, if row is true, then user, which is equal to user of star row. Star row will return all the column into the database like ID, username and password. Here in else part, set user to none and return the user. Okay, now copy this function and paste it over here and rename it to find by ID and provide ID as a parameter. Change over here and also here. Okay, so the function is now created. Now go back to the security file. Here instead of using mapping, we are going to call this method. So user.find by username and here user dot find by ID. Okay, save the both the file. I think it's all ready done. Minimize it and open the Postman. So that's how you can create a user table. Now try to make item table by yourself. If you have any doubt, then I provide code in the description. Also, you can write the comment to the me. Okay, so the Postman is open. Okay, now go to the P2 and hover over here for authentication. Clone it. Here use sign up into the body. I think we already did it. Okay, so for that we need to run the application. So from the command line, go to that particular directory, sorry it's indexed. Okay, application is works perfectly. Now send the request. There is something error in SQLite 3. Get back to the code. Now here it comes values and it's Q2. Save the file and send the request again. Okay, you can see user is created. Now go to the authentication, send the request, it's a invalid credential. So for that, add back to the class, and you need to add another decorator, say class method, and here over self you can write CLSS. Here also written CLSS, and add decorator over here, class method. Okay, save the file, send the request again. Okay, so get back to the security. Here no need to provide none now. Save the file and send the request again. Okay, you can see the access token over here. So that's how you can add the SQLite3 database with your application. You can see over here it's the data.db is created. You can open it and check the user ABC password ABC. You are not able to read this, but database is created. So that's all. If you are continuing this YouTube series, then don't forget to hit like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.